Hey everyone, Daniel here from Twin Bytes with another quick tutorial for you. This time on how to encrypt a bunch of documents that you want to send to somebody by email. And I've done a video on this before where sending an individual document like a PDF and you want to encrypt that one file. And there's features available for that in other software. Now, this is having a series of documents that you would go through a zip utility to compress the files, which even though you may not need to compress them, that's the process of giving us the prompt to then put a password on it. So it doesn't matter what kind of documents you're sending or what format they're in, you just have them all in a folder like we've got here in this confidential folder, and we've got a bunch of documents here that we want to encrypt. So the first thing you want to do is go to 7-zip.org, and you have a few options right at the top of the screen here. The most recent stable version is at the top, where you've got the option of a 32-bit or 64-bit. I would recommend downloading the 64-bit unless you already have a 32-bit Windows for some reason, which you shouldn't, but if you are using that, then this would be the one to get. Otherwise, go with the 64. If you want to go with the latest version for some other features that might be available, you can do that, but this is a non-stable version, which is why it says alpha here after the version number. To download it, you can just click the file, save first, and then run. Depending on what browser you're using, if it's Google Chrome or Firefox, it'll show up at the top of your screen or at the bottom. But once you download it, you should already know how to download files. So that's a whole other video we got to make for you if you don't know how to download things. But you would run it. This is where it's going to default to the destination directory. So you just run the install, and it's going to want you to restart your computer. Once you restart the computer, you're now able to compress the files. And it is so simple. As simple as right-clicking on that folder, going up to 7-zip, and within here you've got a few options, but you want to choose the first one to add to archive. If you select any option other than that, it's not going to prompt you for a password. It's just simply going to compress the set of files and create that zip folder or 7z folder. So we'll go to add to archive. You can change the name if you want, and the format here, I believe, defaults to 7Z for the format, but if you want to make sure that they can open it in other software, you can choose ZIP instead of the default or any of the others, which would force them to have to download other software. But you'll see in a minute you might need the other software anyway. So aside from the name and the archive format, you're going to want to put in a password. And you definitely do not want to put a password that is that weak, because as strong as the encryption algorithms could be, all someone needs to get into this is the password. And if they just assume based on your name or because you were emailing them the password or something like that, they would have the password and get into it and have access to everything. So make sure it's a strong password. Do not email the password to them, but you could text it to them or just simply call them with it. I'm just going to keep it simple just so that we can see how this works. So we've got the name, archive format, a password. Now this is showing us the password because no one's looking over our shoulder as we do this. Otherwise, you could have that turned off and you'll have to enter it twice to make sure you have it right. The encryption method is important to know. The default encryption method is zip crypto, and that would allow you to have a basic level encryption, at least, that would be compatible with almost any zip program. Especially if you're choosing the zip archive format, then they'll be able to open it with their built-in Windows zip utility. AES-256 is a much stronger algorithm for encrypting files, so this would be recommended for a more secure password or more secure encryption. The password is up to you how strong you're going to make that. But with this encryption, they would not be able to open the file using their built-in program, even though you chose the archive format as zip. I've tried this already multiple times. It only comes up with error messages. So if you're sending it to somebody that is not capable of figuring out how to download 7-zip and get that installed to unzip the files, and there you don't want to deal with that incompetence, then you can simply leave the encryption method as zip crypto and it'll work for them much easier. But if it's sensitive information and you have to get it to them, and you need to make sure it's encrypted at the strongest level possible, then they're going to have to just learn how to download and install software. So I would recommend going with the AES 256 and make sure you got a strong password. So hit OK. It creates a file with the extension that you told it, whether it's 7Z or zip. So in this case, we've got the zip format. And if I was to try and extract all from here, I'm getting error messages. And it's not a very helpful message, but this is what happens because we had this with the AES 256 encryption. So we're not able to use the built-in zip utility that comes with Windows. You need to have 7-zip installed, and then you can say to extract the files. I've already got the folder because it's on my computer, so it wouldn't make sense to be unzipping it to the same folder. The person you're sending it to would not have this kind of a prompt because the folder wouldn't exist yet. So I'm just going to tell it to auto rename, and now we're prompted to put in our password. So now if I look at the folder it unzipped to, there's the copies of the files that it's now unzipped. And that's basically it. That's how you can encrypt your files and send them to anybody, making sure that your confidential information stays confidential. But remember to make sure that it's only as safe as how strong of a password you create. Alright, that's it for this tutorial. Thanks so much for watching. If you found it helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. We'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.